Hello po.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. You're from... Ano po name niyo, ma'am?
Geraldine Labradores.
Geraldine?
Fair Trade Organization or Social Enterprise in, based in Cebu.
Where in Cebu po, ma'am?
We have a Fair Trade shop in Cebu City, but our processing plant is in Unayaganaga. Mm. And we partner with several farmers organizations, women and youth. No? Currently, we are having partnership with 34 community organizations, 12 of which are fair trade villages, which means fair trade, they produce part of the products, you know, that we make. For example, they're part of our whole value chain. For coconut, we have 10. And then for moringa, we have 2. Mm-hmm. Currently, but we're still increasing with 2 more. 10 communities for coconut are already producing desiccated coconut. So from the desiccated coconut, we buy it, and then we do the consolidation and processing of the virgin coconut oil. Mm. So as fair trade villages, they have their own facilities for drying, for cutting, for grinding, and for drying the meat of the coconut. And then they also produce and recycle the coconut shell into coconut charcoal as an alternative source of energy. So for the 2 other communities, we produce moringa to them. So they process moringa into flakes, and then we buy it, and then we consolidate the product into moringa powder.
So again po, ang products ninyo is yung moringa.
Yes, turmeric. Virgin coconut oil. Desiccated coconut. These are the ones that has a value chain, which means a partnership with fair trade villages.
Mm-hmm.
But the SFPC also produces
calamansi.
Sourcing direct raw materials from farmers organization. And you also produce dried mango.
Yes.
And mango puree, sourcing raw material from our community farmers.
How big po na is your community? How many members po?
34. We partner with 34 farmers organization in Cebu and Southern Philippines.
Mm-hmm. And then this is available for export din po?
Not all. Currently, what we are able to export now are the dried mango, the virgin coconut oil, and the calamansi extract. Moringa is in the next leg for export. Also.
Iba po ang moringa is malunggay?
Yes.
Yun.
It's scientific name.
Yun.
It is very rich in vitamins and minerals. No? Mm-hmm. So it's 6 times richer of vitamin C than orange. So it's very good for health and wellness. Mm-hmm. Not only for the adults, but much more for kids.
Among the products that you mentioned, ano po yung pinaka-popular or pinaka-best na yung mabili?
Pinaka-well accepted? Locally, we would say that turmeric, calamansi extract, and moringa moves faster, no? In Cebu and even here in Manila, we think, no? But when you talk about export, the dried mango, the virgin coconut oil is on the lead for those products.
Ano po yung price range ng mga products po ninyo?
Well, the dried fruits, by the way, the particularity of our products, we don't have food preservatives and food coloring.
So all original, wala pong preservatives.
Yes, naturally processed, and then the coconut and moringa and turmeric are organically or naturally grown raw materials. No? So we hope it can be certified organic for coconut, moringa and turmeric, and hopefully calamansi. But mangoes is to be in a challenging state. because Philippines and even much more in Cebu as one of the sources of mango, we still have a very small volume for organic mango. Mm. So it's a challenge because of climate challenges also. We need to address this with the Department of Agriculture and among the farmers as well.
So for example, now this one, how much is this?
This 130.
130.
So the product ranges from 80 to like for 150 for 500 grams of moringa, that's 600, no? So it ranges from 80 to 600 pesos.
80 to 600. So ano po yung 600 diyan?
The 600 is moringa for half kilo. But that's so much volume already, huh?
This one po yan?
That's 500 grams.
This one is 600 pesos for half kilo. Yes. Half kilo to.
Actually, when you produce dried moringa, when you dry it, we need 17 to 19 kilos of leaves. Very good leaves at the store.
17.
Yes.
17.
17 to 19. Kilos of leaves, no? Mm-hmm. That the women have to sort out carefully, taking out the ones with aphids, cleaning it very well, and then so that they can dry it, no? Mm-hmm. So 1 kilo is derived from at the maximum 19 kilos of moringa leaves.
So parang meron kayong plantation ng
actually farms of communities.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have several communities nga po pala.
Yes, yes.
So like that, parang so ganun ng
that's how
kadami.
And these are our women farmers.
So that's how they dry it?
Yeah.
Nakasabit.
They dry it for a while, air dry, and then do the final consolidation through a dryer.
Ah, so may mechanical din na ginagamit? Yes. Okay.
Because we have to ensure that the moisture is based on pharmaceutical standards.
Mm.
Like 7 to 9%. Otherwise, they decide to capsule it. Kung hindi siya low moisture, it might cause molds and some micro problems. So we have to ensure that we follow good standards also in the production of moringa.